participants of the program, we shall have speeches and a presentation of the oriki of our dear departed Chief Bola Ike. We enjoin all of those who are standing within the arena to kindly find a seat. There are enough seats here for us all. I'd also like to remind us all that at the Chapel of Christ the Light, the Central Business District, alongside Kenya, Sunday there is a service organized by the Lagos State Government as part of the ongoing Outpost Members Day service. Please be there. I invite us all now for the withdrawal hymn.
As we sing the withdrawal hymn, the Central Choir will recite the full name.
Yeah.
During this segment of the program, we shall have speeches and the presentation of the Ricky of our dear departed Chief Bola Ige. We join all of those who are standing within the arena to kindly find a seat. There are enough seats here.
Thank you. Based on man's existence on earth. Even now, this is true for the end. So, see, this is what Adonai, in our midst, is accompanying him by the command by Commissioner. will pardon me. If I forego the noble Hibernian tradition of a theology all of the distinguished people who are gathered here today, I beg the pardon of the governors and the deputy governors, and fall back instead upon another Hibernian tradition, and merely say all protocol observed. I thank Governor for inviting me here to take part in this ceremony. I will tomorrow be speaking in Iran and giving a longer address than the brief remarks that I want to make here today. Ever since the return of democracy and civilian rule, my wife and I have looked forward to our visits to Nigeria with joyous anticipation. For the first time since then, however, the circumstances of our return are extremely bleak. We had expected to greet Bola Ige in America this month as he took up his assignment as a member of the United Nations International Law Commission. Now, instead, I stand here before the coffin of a man I admire so much that I am overcome with an ineffable sadness. I wish to pay my respects to his family, to some of the others who are here, and to his beloved younger brother. Before us lies the great man who defended the rule of law and the fair long before a ministerial title emblematic of his life's work was conferred upon him. Here lies a champion of freedom and honesty, who, with his pen and his voice, proved that both were mightier than the military sword. Here lies our Cicero, slain by cowardly wolves. Although they have succeeded in cutting short the life of Mr. Honorable Man, they have not, they will not, they cannot curtail the newly established democracy he did so much for. Terrorists can destroy lives, but they cannot crush the spirit of a people. And what are assassins if they are not terrorists who hope cycle opposition by instilling a climate of fear and retaliation? But I say to you this day, what I am sure Uncle Bola would say, if only we could hear his reassuring voice again. Be not afraid, neither be confused. Rather, let us resolve to make sure that in this nation, the culture of assassination never gains hospitable soil in which to grow. Nigeria is at another of its historic crossroads. The next year may well determine whether it is capable of sustaining the democracy we approach another election in 2003. The political class must prove itself worthy of the trust those who elected them to office have reposed in them. That trust will be betrayed if murder and corruption, rather than reason debate, become the politicians' sovereign decree. I believe, as did Ola Ihe, in the potential greatness of this country. Blessed with riches of its natural resources and the intelligence and industry of its people. Blessed beyond all others on this continent of my ancestors. Nigeria must now rise up to claim its rightful place as one of the leading nations of the world. To do so, those who seek to lead the people must abandon the old ways, which became known as the Nigerian Pact. In honoring the memory of Ola Ihe, we must never forget the ideals for which he stood and which no blemishes, no temptations, no threats could get him to abandon. As we return Ola Ihe's noble body to the soil of liberty's frame, let us resolve to keep faith with that passage of the national anthem which proclaims that the labors of our heroes past shall never be in vain. May he now be reunited with those heroes, many of whom in life were his comrades, and in death like him, will be remembered and revered by generations yet unborn. Remembered and revered wherever men and women struggle to be free. Remembered and revered so long as the sons and daughters of Mother Africa on the continent and in the diaspora dwell upon this earth, then truly will Ola Ihe live forever.
Thank you very much, sir. Next up, Paul Long.
Excuse me, could you please be quiet?
I'm going to go to the hospital. Love.
war, the criminals, the damage. We are used to our church that we are fully at home with its capabilities and the government and the war. The Lord is the greatest of our masters. To open your house to all, I come to the occasion, you will be able to stand like this and accept the privileges of them that you have. The Lord protects and protects the people. The Lord protects you with yourself and against the masters. The Lord is the Lord and is free for you.
Thank you. Thank you.